Hello everybody and welcome to this channel. On this episode I'm going to introduce to you a historical enclave in Iran. So stay tuned. Pesargedi is a collection of ancient structures from the Achaemenid era, which is located in a high plain at an altitude of 1900 meters above sea level in Fars province. The name of Pesargedi was mentioned for the first time in the Achaemenid period, which refers to the area that 25 centuries ago Cyrus the Great chose as his command center and the first capital of Achaemenid Empire. The main enclosure with 160 hectares floor area is surrounded and protected by the Zagros Mountains. Pesargedi has historical monuments including the tomb of Cyrus the Great in the south, Toletacht fortifications on the north, the tomb of Cambyses I, in addition to the audience and private palaces in the center. This enclave has been registered in the UNESCO World Heritage List in 2004. Four main types of materials were used in the construction of these buildings, including stone, brick, raw clay, and wood. Wood was predominantly utilized for making gates and roofs. In some places, thick trunks of cedar trees were also applied for columns. Raw clay was employed for repointing bricks of the walls and platforms. The bricks implemented in Pesargedi are red, and their mortar is a type of natural bitumen that prevents water penetration. Their example can also be seen in Elamite architecture. There are several types of stones exploited in the buildings of Pesargedi, which were sourced from the mountains around this complex. One of them is white limestone and the other one is black rough stone, which remarkably are still durable after 25 centuries. Following the archaeological research in 1820, the identity of the most prominent part of Pesargedi enclave was revealed as the tomb of Cyrus the Great. This sepulchre was built from white limestone around 540 BC. The mausoleum building was located among the royal gardens and made of large stones, some of which are 7 meters long, that are connected with metal fasteners. The 11 meter high burial place has two main parts, including a 6-step platform that its base is rectangular with a floor area of 165 square meters and a chamber with a floor area of 7.5 square meters, which has a sloping roof and the thickness of its walls reaches 1.5 meters. Following Cyrus' demise in a war with Scythians, his body was embalmed and his jewelry was placed next to him in his sarcophagus. However, during the invasion of Persia led by Alexander Macedonian, all of them were looted. The design of Cambyses I mausoleum is a combination of burial and religious architectures, the structure of which looks like the other burial places in Naqsh-e Rustam necropolis and was built on the northern periphery of the private palace ground in the form of a tall stone tower that the remnants of which still remain today. The total height of the burial chamber reaches 14 meters. This building consisted of a cube-shaped tower with several rows of windows on the four sides of the edifice. The base of the tower was built on a 3-step platform. The entrance of this sepulchre was connected to the ground level by several stairs. Pesargedi had a citadel known as Toletacht with defensive rampart encircling the whole city. This place has a floor area of 8,000 square meters with a height of 15 meters. The stronghold with thick walls made of stone and clay surrounded a parallelogram-shaped area with dimensions of 98 by 79 meters. On the western side of this part, a large colonnaded hall with the dimensions of 25 by 7 meters has been built, which had 8 cylindrical columns. In the northern side of Toletecht, there were 2 stairs to reach to the top of the structure, of which not much remains today. Most of the stones of the outer walls were connected with special metal fasteners. The petroglyph of the winged man stands out as one of the most impressive patterns created among other carvings in Pesargedi, which shows a man with a short beard, a long fringed robe, and a crown on his head, facing the center of the palace. 4 wings elegantly cover both sides of the man, while 2 of them spread towards the sky and the others towards the earth. The engraving was inspired by the art and cultures of different nations in that era, including the crown of Egyptian origin, the Elamite robe, and the wings, which have roots in Assyrian art. The use of different art of nations in one sculpture symbolizes equality among cosmopolitans during that epoch. Audience Palace was built on the northwest side of this enclave, occupying 2,472 square meters. This palace included a wide central hall with 8 columns, which is 705 square meters in floor area. Out of the 8 columns of this hall, only one is standing with a height of 13 meters. The central hall was connected to the 4 porches of the palace. This edifice served as a venue where the king received dignitaries from different parts of the Achaemenid Empire to discuss various issues. The private palace of the king was situated within the garden complex in the center of Pesargedi and consisted of pillared halls which had 2 rows of 4 columns. The base of the columns is made of black stone, approximately 1.5 by 1.5 meters, and their body is made of white limestone, with 12 meters in height. This part had 2 pavilions located in the east and south of the royal garden. These buildings, with approximate dimensions of 11 by 10 meters, consisted of a quadrangular stone platform. The private palace undoubtedly shows the influence of Greek architecture in its structure. The cylinder of Cyrus is a barrel shaped of baked clay that was inscribed in 530 BC. This cylinder is kept in the British Museum. The relic consists of 2 parts. The first piece has 35 lines and the second one includes 10 lines, which were discovered separately in the excavations. The length of this cylinder is 22.5 centimeters and its width at its thickest part is 10 centimeters. The inscription of this cylinder is in cuneiform letters and contains a narrative of the conquest of Babylon by Cyrus, and it begins with a speech by Marduk, the Babylonian god, denouncing the atrocities of Nabonides, the last Chaldean king. Moreover, in the subsequent part of this story, Marduk begins searching to find a worthy king, paying homage to Cyrus and mentions his role in liberating of Babylon. Then Cyrus enumerates his titles and lineage in the first person tone and declares that he has guaranteed the peace of the country, by which he and his son Cambyses II are granted the mercy of Marduk. In the following, Cyrus proclaims the reconstruction of the temple, which had been neglected during the reign of Nabonidus, and his permission for the exiles to return to their homeland, and finally the rebuilding of the fortifications of Babylon city. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Let me know your opinion in the comments section. And if you would like, please subscribe to my channel and wait for new videos.